President Kiev! The next seminar we have here on the Star Stage Barometer 2019 has got my favorite title, The Metrics of Happiness. It's run by two of my friends, Paul and Alexi, and I want you to give them a huge welcome when I bring them on stage, because I want to feel that happiness coming from you at the beginning, and I really want to see it at the end. Paul comes from Transylvania, so you can bring out all your Dracula jokes. Alexi is from Kiev, co-owner of Bar S34. They're both head trainers for Diageo Bar Academy here in Eastern Europe. So, can I be here? A huge Kiev welcome for the Metrics of Happiness, the dynamic duo of Paul and Alexi! Woo!
Check. Hello and good morning, everybody. I'm so happy to be here. Thank you for the energy. I just want to start with something very simple. Just want to explain that happiness, it's an inside job. And this was the best lesson that I learned from my son. He's 2 years old, and he's more joyous. Every single moment of his small life is more joyous than me. So, from the moment he was born, I took him as a guru. So he's my baby guru, because there was a time when we went out and it started raining. And when I saw rain, having him, I said, okay, let's go home now. We have to go home. And he was like dancing in the rain. And I said, no, no, something is wrong with us. So happiness, you can find it more at a little baby, at a small child, than you can find it in an adult life. So let's have a look on that, because today, what we want to talk about, it's metrics, which means measuring, and happiness, which everybody knows what happiness means. So we want today to learn how to measure our happiness. And the reason why we want to measure our happiness, besides because we want to be happy, is because if we are happy in the hospitality industry, we can make our guests happy. If we are not happy in the hospitality industry and our happiness measuring is very low, the moment when you go into the bar, you work into the bar, and a guest enters into your bar and sees you with a sad face, that's the feeling that you transmit. That's the vibe, that's the memory that he will take from that experience in your bar or restaurant. When he will leave, he will not remember what you said to him. He will not remember mostly the recipes or the cocktails. He will remember the way you made them feel. So this is the main reason why today we decided to talk about the metrics of happiness and how important it is to be happy and joyful in the hospitality industry. It's important for us, firstly. Secondly, it's important for our guests. So stay with us here. We have a lot of surprises. And the first surprise comes from... I ruined the surprise.
Don't be so fast.
So now a little research. The British scientists have proved that people who dance are 2 times happier than those who don't dance. So now I've got a short question for you. Would you raise the hand if you know how to dance Macarena? Okay, cool, super, nice. Then we'll have just a very short lesson on Macarena. I will need the help of each of you. First of all, I would ask you to rise. Yeah, I understand. The drinks should be put aside. And now we'll have a little lesson before we really are the people who are the dancers. The first movement we are practicing now, the right hand, arm straight ahead. Then the second one, three. Then we put the palm above. Then we do the same with the left hand, five. Then the right palm to the left shoulder. Then the same with the left hand. Then we put the right hand behind the head. The same with the left hand. Who knows the following step? No, this next movement. Yes, the right hand goes to the butt, and then the same with the left one. Then we have a small turn and jump. Totally right. Do we need to repeat it, or shall we dance instantly again? Okay, perfect. So, the first movement, the right one, the left one, two. Then the right palm, yes, the left palm, yes. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. That's already much nicer, 10. And then the next is the turn and the jump. To the left, I have forgotten to tell you, to the left, the jump to the left. So we won't repeat it for the third time or another rehearsal. Do you need another one? The third time? Okay. Cool. Now?
Everybody ready? Let's play some music.
There is a request. Let's turn on some music. So the surprise effect is a bit late.
Now.
Stop, 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 stop. Just.
Okay, let us all do again, because that was a bit wrong.
But please, everybody, the guys from the back, join us. Please join us. You need to do this in order to enjoy the whole rest of the session. Please, everybody, join us. Don't be lazy. I know it was a hard night. Please join us, everybody. I see you. Stand up, stand up. It's important to raise the energy before starting what we want to say. Really. It's very relevant for what we want to say. So please come in with us in the session.
Let's see.
Go.
Начинаем.
Let us begin.
В команде три будет так, чтобы вместе все начать.
Go, go, go. One more time! Whoa! Thank you very much, everybody!
Я вас поздравляю. Теперь мы...
So I congratulate you, because now we are in the second group of the people, according to the opinion of the British scientists. And now, Paul...
Part of the icebreaker. We need the energy. We need you to raise up a little bit the energy. We know that it was a hard line last night. We heard the bars, the drinks that you have. So we need to be focused here. We need to increase a little bit the level of the energy, because I will tell you how this will happen. We will start and we will build the session, and we will build the level of the energy. We will build the happiness inside you. This is what we try to do here, to increase the level of the happiness inside yourself. So first thing I want to discuss with you about three types of happiness. Beside the fourth type, this is like the base where we start. Unfortunately, in our society, happiness and success translates into this. If you are very good, if you do plenty of things, if you travel, if you have fun, if you are a really successful person, inside, you are not so happy. You are stressed, you are anxious, you are afraid. And you are not enjoying the happiness, you're not enjoying the things that you achieve. We are achieving a lot of things. Every single day we achieve things. Let's enjoy them. Let's live them. Let's be happy about those things. So, first impression when you go into the bar and you see the bartender like this, his level of happiness is on the ground. Maybe he's upset because he has rent to pay, he has a child, he has to bring money home, he's not making enough money, his owner is not paying enough, he's working 16 to 18 hours per day. He has plenty of reasons to be like this. So let's start from here. I think you can relate, you can empathize with this state, at least one or two times in your life when your face was looking like this. Because what starts from the inside, it will show on the outside. So we should work on the inside in order to express it on the outside. Because the face and the eyes and the mouth is the mirror of what we feel inside. So let's build it a little bit. First type of happiness, it's a simple smile. Come on, show me your smile. Show me your smile. It's so simple to show, it's like a simple smile. Have you noticed, if you go on the street and you smile to somebody, you don't even know him, and you smile to him, he's smiling back? Is this happening to you? Where do you live? Who said no? So I know I won't come there. Smile is contagious. And it's a simple, you make your mouth bigger, you show your teeth a little bit, and you smile. It's so simple. And this is the first step of the happiness. Happiness starts with a smile. And the interesting thing is, when you smile, you cannot be upset. When you really smile, when you're not just the McDonald's smile. You want some fries and an ice cream? No, when you really smile, try next time when you really smile to think about the problems you have. See if those problems affect you so hard as they affect you when you are not smiling. Because this is what smiles do. It reflects on the inside. It's an NLP study that you can program yourself by programming the outside, the body, the face. And by programming by the outside, forcing an honest smile, soon it will translate into a joyful feeling, into a more pleasant feeling. So next time, first level of happiness, when you are down, when you are very down, think about, okay, I should smile. Smile at least 5 minutes. Try it. And to be honest, I don't want you to believe me of anything that I'm saying today, because we are not in the church here. Please try it. Explore my ideas, our ideas. Take them back to the place where we are working and explore them. If they are not working for you, we talked only bullshit. But if they are working, now you have something that you can improve your life with. This is what we want to make here, to give you some tools to improve your state of being, to improve your joy, to improve your inner happiness, and to transform it, and to explain it and give it to the people in front of you. I did a thing at some point in 2015. I've been to South Africa, Cape Town, in World Class, in the Global Finals, and I had this poor, because I knew, I study a lot the smile, and there were some studies that they were saying, if you can make somebody else smiling, he's like emotional depository, is called. He's feeling that he wants to give the same positive feeling back to you. So if you can make somebody smile or laugh, he will give you these positive feelings back. So I knew this, and I went to mixology competitions and bartending competitions, and I knew the first thing that I have to do, I have to make the judges smile. Because if they were smiling, they couldn't judge me so harsh. So first thing, I had to make them smile. I was thinking, how can I make the judges smile? I'm not so creative, it seems. So I put a big smile on my hand, and the moment when I was pouring, all the judges were like, they were smiling. And you know Gary Regan? I think you know him. He's like a big legend in the industry. Like 4 months ago or 5 months ago or something, he did a video about mindfulness bartending, where he was explaining the reason why he is doing the finger stir Negroni. And he said that the main reason why he is doing the finger stir Negroni is to make people in front of him smile. This is the main reason. And he remembered, like after 4 years, he remembered that moment in that competition. He judged me in that competition. And he actually said that he saw this thing, and you can find the video on YouTube. He did a pour and he had a big smile on his hand, because he remembered about this. I made him smile and he remembered me. Because the idea is, when you make the people, when you make the world, when you make them smile, the world smiles back to you. So try to smile more. This is like the first, the basic step of the happiness. Start with a smile, because happiness starts with a smile. It takes nothing, it costs nothing. You just smile. It's so simple. While I dare you, while you get out of this room and you walk around Barometer, smile to the people and see if they will smile back to you. Try it. Don't trust me, try it. Go out and smile. We need more smile in the world. Because the industries that we have, our jobs are so hard, so intense, that at some point we forgot to smile and we are bartenders. This thing will be replaced very soon by machines. It's simple. There will be machines that will make this thing. We will just make and smile to the world. We will transmit the feeling. This is what we have, and machines cannot replace. These feelings, transmitting happiness to other people. Second step toward the big happiness. Start with a smile, costs nothing. Second step, laugh. So after you smile and you really feel the smile and it's not a fake smile and you started, maybe inside it was hard. You started with a smile for 5 minutes and at some point people are starting smiling to you back and you create this energy and you create the context when the laugh can happen. Because laugh doesn't happen when you are sad. Laugh doesn't happen when you are angry. Laugh can happen only when you create the context of laugh. So what we wanted to do with the dance, with everything we did now, we wanted to create the context of the laugh. So we try to create the context of you, for you, your inner part, to be open for laugh. And I will ask you to do a test. We have a laughometer here, and we would like to measure your laugh, because even laugh have a few stages. This looked interesting. I didn't know it also. Rotflmao, which means actually rolling on the floor, laughing my ass off. So when you smile like this, when you laugh like this, your whole body is ecstatic. You feel no pain, only pure happiness. You feel nothing. You cannot think about any problem. When you laugh like this, you are just laughing. And your body is enjoying every single second of laughing. So we would like to try to test, to measure your laugh. And we will do this with a short video. My quest to you, I would kindly ask you, don't keep the laugh inside. Don't do like... you have here, when you start here, it's like... when you go a little bit upper, it's like... when you go more, it's ha ha ha. When you go even more, it's oh no. And then you go ah, and this, do you want me to show you this?
Yes.
So let's measure your laugh. Don't keep the laugh inside. If you feel it, let it out. Laugh is contagious. Everybody saw it, yeah, I think. It's contagious. To the laughometer. Where were you? Raise the hand who was here. Heh. You were like, heh. Okay. Who was like, heh. Raise the hand who was, heh. Okay. Raise the hand who was, ha ha ha. Okay, so we are here. Raise the hand who was, ha ha ha. So there were a few. Raise the hand who was here. Thank you. We should talk after. You should learn me how to do that. So this is the laugh step. Don't keep the laugh inside. At some point, you want to laugh. You go on the street, you see a funny thing, and you are like... Don't keep it back. Don't push it back. Because it's everywhere. It's in our life. I see my baby every single day, every single hour. I think there are no 5 minutes in a row that he's not laughing at something. It's stupidly, but it's so funny. And he's teaching me so many things. We can laugh about anything. You can laugh about me. You can laugh about you. You can laugh about anything. Just don't keep it back. Give it to the world, and the world will take it back to you. Because what you give to the world it gives back to you. I don't know how many times you walked into the bar, and it was a very quiet night. Nobody came at the bar, and you were like a proper mixologist. But when the bar is full and everybody's having lots of fun and they were like, wow, you're a superstar bartender, I fucking love you, wow. You are in the bar like, woohoo! It's a different energy. You are giving them your energy and they will give the energy back. Don't go into the bar your next shift and lose it and not laugh at least one time with a guest, with a colleague. Laugh with your colleagues, laugh with your guests. Don't let it in. We are professionals, but we can laugh, and we need to laugh, because if we don't laugh, machines will replace us. Because machines can do these things, but machines cannot transmit and create the context of laughing. So when you are not afraid to laugh, you make room for something else. And the third thing that I would like to talk about, the third type of happiness, you cannot create it. You need to create the perfect context and the perfect condition for it to appear. And this is, not this. And this is joy. This is a pure happiness. This is the long-term happiness, because sometimes happiness for somebody means I buy something, I buy a new car, I'm so happy. And you are happy for a whole week. And after that week, you are thinking, I can buy an even bigger car. So happiness is not about what you achieve, especially joy comes from inside. But you have to create the context for it to appear. So I have like three suggestions. Taking it from the first sad step that you saw, going it through a smile, leave out the laugh from you, and then after leaving out the laugh, you can start building it. And you can, first, the transformation is within. It starts from the outside. It starts from the smiling outside. But from the laugh, it's from inside already. You create the context from the outside. You transform it. You transport it inside. And then you create the perfect conditions for joy to appear, because joy appears. You cannot pursue joy. You cannot follow joy. You cannot do actions in order to be joyful. No, joy comes when you are ready. Take it step by step. And when is the moment when you feel that you really, honestly, let your laugh going out to the world, that moment you can start thinking about transforming in, within. Search for the joy within you. Second thing. Being joyful, it's your fundamental responsibility. World has no responsibility to make you joyful. Only you are responsible of your joy. Nobody will make it for you. It's your absolute responsibility. You have to work for it. You have to do the work. You have to do whatever it takes to create the context in order for joy to appear. So it's from you. When you look in the mirror, be honest with you. Take all the masks that society is putting on us and look what you have and explore that. Stay with it. Embrace it. That's you. Third thing. Stop creating. Start expressing. What you have inside, that's the one thing that you can give to the world. That thing makes you unique. Express that. That's called art. That's the moment when bartending is becoming an art. When bartending and what we do in the bar and how we talk with the people, it's exactly the mirror that we have inside. And it's not a fake feeling. We are here at the Joy now. And I want to thank you very much. I will pass it to Alexei to take you even further. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Paul.
Welcome.
Теперь давайте продолжим.
And now let's continue. And those steps are the important steps because we mostly think about providing great service, but in general what the manager is thinking is how to teach people to serve properly, to stand straight, to have like this white shirt. And it's also important, but the most important thing is to work with yourself, because the quality of product will reach its limit very soon. The competition between the establishments will be in the service that they are providing. That's why we emphasize this. Why service? Because it's one of the most important aspects of business. This is why we're talking about this today. Can you hear me well? Can you hear me all right? Great, amazing. And in fact, the main task is to create a unique impression. If you just prepare a good drink and you serve it, there's nothing complicated about that. Almost any establishment can do it. If they just Google, you know, the recipe, look it up, it's not complicated at all. But to create a unique impression that the client will remember, this is complicated. And to do something that will be memorable, to do something that will be unique, everybody dreams about the word of mouth. Everybody says that the word of mouth is the best marketing, but how do we create the word of mouth? Only thanks to unique impression. There can be two types of unique impression, the product and the service. And we are talking about the service now. And let's talk about some aspects. We don't need to teach people only how to walk and how to serve correctly. We also need to teach our employees to be great people. And the characteristics of a great person. And the first characteristic of a great person is honesty. Everybody remembers 10 years ago where bartenders cooked under the table. There was no trust to a bartender. Now, until now, the guests don't really believe the bartenders. They think that they put like too much ice in the drink to, you know, fool you or something. But now we can just recommend, employee can recommend something, and this is also part of their honesty. They say like, I like this drink, I like this dish, that's why I recommend it. And this is how the client can see that they're honest, and we should emphasize this. Next point is training. Now, currently, finally, it became fashionable in Ukraine to train to study. In Europe, it has existed for a long time. You not just finish college or like university and go to work. It became fashionable, it became trendy to do lifelong learning. And there are many people who also take up additional degrees. So the client is also ready to study. But the important thing, studying doesn't have to be snobbish for the client. There was this great example. There was a great example that Paul made about the mixologist who, with a serious face, they mix the drinks, they prepare the drinks like 5 minutes each. But then again, the emphasis should be on the recommendation and also on training, on teaching. For some people, it's interesting. For some people, it's not. But we need to bring in something new, some small ideas. It doesn't have to be something like extraordinary, but it's very important to teach, to train. And the next idea is nostalgia. I think it's one of the simplest ways to influence people. And to be honest, several years ago, I didn't quite get this idea of like disco from the 80s parties. But 5 years in, I realized that I would go to a party that seemed like disco from the 90s, because when you're nostalgic, you can find the audience, you can find your target audience, and by making these theme parties, of course, like in cocktail bars, in many establishments, we can't do it, it's just an example, but if you create this 80s disco event, we understand like which generation are going to come to see us. Of course, like younger people will probably not visit this kind of party. I'm almost sure about that. But there are different ways to influence people, like something that used to be fashionable. I saw like Tetris shaped menu somewhere. And this is a unique impression, like Tetris shaped menu or like serving a drink like on this game. What does a client do when they come? They take a picture and they tell their friends about it. So it's very simple, like nothing extraordinary. But using the simple ideas, we build up. And then the great example, it's not an advertising, but Paravoz made a cream soda and people have been drinking it for years and they're ecstatic. Like all the bloggers are saying, Paravoz cream soda is so great. And other bars also started copying it. Everybody who drank cream soda earlier, they know how tasty it is. And this is also gives you this nostalgic feeling to the client. And of course, we can do without the social factor. What's going on here and now in our society? People who live in Kyiv last year noticed when we had these floods, these small floods, because of rain, like underground pedestrian crossings were flooded, and there were like many memes online with our mayor who sort of like swims out of this underground pedestrian crossing. How can we use this? We can do like simple jokes, we can do themed drinks, meme themed drinks, such a drink as Red Bull, for example. Deadpool 2, when it was launched last year, at least a dozen bars in Kyiv, they had a Deadpool cocktail. Like, some people don't like it, but many were waiting for this movie to come out. And the three bars where I put different Deadpool cocktails, they were like bestsellers for 3 months, because I just understood this was important for the society, and I just chose what was trendy. Ecological things, like environmental-friendly things, can also be trendy, or dog-friendliness can also be a trendy thing as well. Our friends, our little brothers, our pets are someone that we worry about very much. And if you come into a bar and you're not allowed with a dog, you already feel pain. So some bars, they on the contrary advertise, on the contrary are proud that they are dog friendly and they write it in their social networks. So you can come, you know, with your small dog and drink a couple cocktails. Of course, nobody will give a drink to your pet, to your dog. But this is something that helps us influence the minds and people. I won't make any more jokes about Kyiv mayor, but people who live in Kyiv, they all remember, they all made those jokes, and they also had to swim through the underground crossings. And of course, I should tell you about my personal experience. All kinds of different moments, like everybody celebrates Halloween in the establishments, in the bars. Please raise your hand who do. What do other people do during Halloween? Anyway, the most simple thing that you can do is to paint yourself, and also to hire an artist who will be doing face painting for people. It's just like paying one person to work a night, but it creates a unique experience and unique impressions. Or like celebrating the anniversary. We created this party for the like second anniversary, and they call it like paper wedding, paper anniversary. And we gave like paper rings out to people, and there was also a priest. And of course, we wanted to make this like ancient Greece party, something like highbrow, but we decided to choose a simpler message, something that will be interesting for everybody. So we ditched the idea with ancient Greece, and we took the wedding idea to celebrate our anniversary. So every societal aspect can be used in a bar, every kind of holiday, like March 8th, and you just take what the society likes and you use it in your business. And now I'm going to need your help with the balloons. I was promised that we're going to have the balloons on stage, and I hope that we're going to have them on stage really soon. I'm not going to dwell much longer on here. Should we choose a gift or a discount? The sale, the discount kills the product, so we won't stop on discount for very long. But what do you associate gifts with? Maybe the girls, they think about March 8th, Women's Day, when they get presents, and maybe the Soviet Army's Day. I haven't received any present for that day for a very long time because my mom left abroad. But anyway, gifts. Everybody likes gifts. And if we give like this very, very small cookie with a coffee cup, it's also a small gift that helps us with our clients and it helps them end their night well. I won't mention the chewing gum, that this small compliment that was given together with the bill earlier, but the gift from the establishment, from the bar, it's also a unique experience that the client has. And now I would like you to also feel that you've received a gift. We're going to throw the balloons, and five of them have a gift inside them. So please break a balloon and take out a piece of paper that's inside it. What kind of a gift you're asking? Please, you can find out when you actually find this piece of paper. So we're gonna start throwing balloons now. There's a paper inside, I remind you. Small remark, you can exchange your gift in our Johnny Walker bar downstairs. And now a small question that I want to ask. What did you feel in 5 of the 20 balloons? There is a gift, there's a surprise factor. You're trying to receive something. The luck isn't yours today, I'm sorry. And the final idea is about creating this excitement, about creating this positive emotion. It's pretty simple. We just threw 20 balloons to the audience. And immediately there are many associations like champagne opening and all that. And at the example of this simple balloon, you understand how much the surprise, the gift can impact our consumer, even the smallest one. And of course, enthusiasm. The way we behave, the way we show this inside happiness, inside joy and enthusiasm. Primarily, we need to make our employees enthusiastic, teach them to be enthusiastic, to communicate enthusiastically.
And of course, care. We all like to feel care. Someone more, someone less, someone doesn't need it at all. But as statistics show, all of us like to be taken care of. Not just to have a drink and to have some joke, but at least to express, if you've seen that something has happened, maybe just to express some attention, some care. Just spend a couple of minutes. It's easy. Just these are the basics, the foundation according to which you can base and construct the whole service. And the main aim, the main target is to exceed the expectations, to give something more than just coming to the cocktail bar or a restaurant, not just to create positive emotions, but to give something more. This is the main message of ours. So, everybody, thank you so much.
Macarena, we go with Macarena. Can we play one more time, Macarena, please? Stand up and then we are finished. You will not see our faces anymore today, only in the barometer. So.
Раз, два.
Everybody. Up, up, don't be shy, don't be shy.
Три. Whoa.
what?
I am not trying to do that.
Good job.
Yes.
Macarena, que tu cuerpo es para dar la alegría y cosas buenas. Baila tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena.